brought the first Gemini Award to Ottawa for their animated special.
That's right, Ian, and that animated special was based on Lynn Johnson's comic strip For Better or For Worse. Now Atkinson's characters are friends to millions of children.
Father Christmas?
Yes?
I'm King Baba. We've heard about you in Celesteville. I have a list of toys from the children.
You and Lizzie can each have one small toy to play with on the way home.
How much is small?
Under $3. All these characters were created in the Atkinson Film Arts Studios in Ottawa.
And so for the very first time, the Velveteen Rabbit began to feel just a little bit what being real is all about.
I think he's a little too goofy looking. We might want to make him a little shorter and a little bit wider in the cheeks. Maybe a little fatter in the body.
Mm-hmm. Once an idea for a cartoon is hatched, the director and chief animator work together to create the characters.
Okay, whiskers. Meat means whiskers. It's not a formula. It's just something that either does something for you or it doesn't. You look at it and you go, oh, I think that's a little off track there. Or you might modify something like just by changing the ears and you go, yeah, that's it.
The background scenery for each of Atkinson's productions is done in this studio. These artists are working on the Teddy Ruxpin 65-episode series. They translate rough outlines into actual scenes and then paint the backgrounds.
Okay, we're rolling.
Meanwhile, the cartoon characters' voices are recorded in the sound studio.
What you're given usually is a little picture of the cartoon character you're going to do. And you put that in your mind, and if it's a short, fat character, you may sound sort of short and fat and chubby, kind of like that. Or you can add special effects to it, like you can do, say, two voices at once. So you've got one voice, and you've got two voices, you know, things like that. Just happens.
What about animals?
Animals? Oh, occasionally you get a call for an animal, like a cat would be a being run over by a car, that kind of thing.
Once the voices have been recorded, animators meticulously draw each movement. There are up to 12 drawings per second in a finished cartoon, and each one is done by hand. Once all the animation is colored, each frame is shot on 35mm film.
No, we're not. We're just...
My company! Oh, it's wonderful! That's so great!
The last stage is the sound mix.
Well, if I'd known we were going swimming, I would have brought my bathing suit, Tweed.
When you're actually watching a cartoon, you're hearing 15 to 20 different soundtracks, each with a different voice, musical sequence, or special effect. There's no doubt that Atkinson Film Arts is a rapidly expanding company. It employs 150 people, and this year expects to do over $5 million worth of business. It's just received a $1 million research and development grant to help computerize its operations. Bill Stevens is the chief executive officer of Atkinson Film Arts. He says their computer programs will be the first in the industry and should reduce costs 25 to 35%.
We're so labor intensive. There are thousands and thousands of drawings in animation, and all those drawings have to go through so many stages of development, right from the initial animator drawing them with pencil through transferring them onto plastic and then painting them and then putting them under the camera one at a time. As you go through the studio, you see these files, and there's an immense file, sometimes this thick, with hundreds of pieces of paper, and then there are hundreds of these files, and they all get put in great big boxes, and these boxes get carted from place to place. And if we can eliminate that by having it all transferred digitally and electronically, that'll be a very big step.
No. The first animation Atkinson did was Little Brown Burrow in 1978. In it, the mice dreamed about going to China.
Imagine the things we'd see if we should go to Cathay.
That dream has come true. Within a few weeks, Atkinson will begin the first co-production with an animation house in China.
Tell me more about the China project.
What they're going to be doing is, for the first project will be a rendition of Hans Christian Andersen's fairy tale, The Nightingale. They've got two Chinese animators who are coming to Ottawa within the next couple of weeks. They've had trouble with their visas, so I don't know exactly when they'll be coming. And then animators from here will be going back to Shanghai, and they're going to actually work together on all the drawings, and it should be really, really good.
I was wondering why you were poking me in the arm until I suddenly realized that wasn't my script I was reading. It was your script I was reading. Sorry.
You did a wonderful job.
Sally, wind me up and away I go. Sally, back tomorrow with the weekend entertainment menu still to come. The weather and sports with Hub Boudry. Stay with us.